So.
All right, money, privilege, intrigue, Hollywood. The newly uncovered college admission scandal has managed to check just about all of the boxes. Actresses Lori Loughlin and Felicity Huffman are among 50 people charged in the largest college cheating scam ever prosecuted. Investors say wealthy parents paid ringleader William Rick Singer, who has already pleaded guilty, a total of $25 million to get their children into top American colleges. The alleged scheme involved bribes, cheating on entrance exams, and fake athletic profiles. Authorities say the parents spent involved anywhere from $200,000 to more than $6 million to guarantee their children's admissions. So, Myron, let's start with you on this. Any surprise here at all?
Oh, not at all. It just shows where, money can determine who gets to do what and who gets to go where. Frankly, I think University of Memphis is always a great choice.
You slid that in there.
Yes, yes. Always a great choice. But unfortunately, there's a lot of things that you can do with your money. And, unfortunately, it's not always the right thing.
Latty, how do you see that there? A lot of folks are saying this is only the tip of the iceberg at that.
Well, it just made me think. So when I was a freshman in high school, I ended up playing varsity sports. Mom? But that's right. I mean, it makes you question a lot of stuff. You know, are you actually that good at being an athlete or academics or whatever? Because a lot of them saying that the parents did it behind the kids' back and they didn't know any better.
Right, right.
And then one of the girls' daughters comes out and says, "Well, I don't even like studying anyway."
Yeah. Like, I heard that sound, but I was like, really?
Right.
Yeah. Well, I have a feeling, as you mentioned, tip of the iceberg here. I think in the back of everybody's mind, we probably thought, especially in college sports, something's going on back there to get certain players to go to certain places. Mm-hmm. You probably think, yeah, this is probably happening, but not to this degree. What'd you say, like $25 million? Mm-hmm. And I have a feeling we're going to be hearing and seeing a lot more about that. And I wonder why they do that. Is that they want to say, oh, my kid goes to Harvard, or my kid goes to Yale, or the kid wants to say, yes, I went to Harvard, or I went to Yale. So I don't know if that's a prestige thing, because it's like, or just the name of the college. What is making them want to go there?
It's going to be collegegofundme.com is what I'm going to be doing here.
Sooner or later, that is for sure.
And I know what we were kind of talking about earlier is, I think a lot of this happens with booster, not even just this kind of stuff. This is athletic. This stuff has been going on for a long time.
Right.
So I know a lot of people on social media were just kind of shocked that this came out, but it's such a big scandal. Maybe it's the amount of money.
Or if somebody's going to jail.
That's for sure.
Yeah, exactly.
All right, got another topic here, Simone.
All right, well, it turns out where you live may determine how happy you are. Get this, at least that's the indication of a new report by personal finance website WalletHub. The site ranked the happiest cities in the U.S. Plano, Texas took the top spot. The study analyzed more than 2.5 dozen happiness indicators. Now, this includes depression rate, income growth rate, and average leisure time per day. Out of 182 cities, Detroit came in last. No city in any of the Mid-South states cracked the top 100. Memphis, though, came in at 164. So what do we think about that, guys?
I'm from Texas originally, so I'm kind of biased.
No.
I was born in Memphis.
Plano, Texas.
Right. So no, but I do agree. I think that in certain places, I mean, it's just like the quality of life is different. Mm-hmm. Do you know what I'm saying? And that doesn't mean like richer or poorer or any of that kind of stuff. It's just like people enjoy more. There's things to do outside. You can go river rafting. You can go hiking or climbing mountains and stuff like that. So I think that also helps it. And of course, Texas is a huge state, and it's a beautiful place as well.
They must have some incredible barbecue restaurants there. That's
the
only thing I can think of.
Brisket down there. It's not the real thing.
I've thought about this before also, and I really think the happiness factor has a lot to do with yourself. I mean, if you're happy with yourself, I think you can be happy just about anywhere. But I like what you were saying about if there's places to hike and there's water. I mean, the amenities that the town has, maybe it's really clean or something like that. So, there's a lot of different things.
It makes you feel better, probably.
Yeah.
I'm thinking Detroit has to feel some type of way about coming in dead last.
You would think.
Yeah. 182 last.
Way down there on the bottom. All right, here's one last one for you. Who doesn't love French fries? Well, now you can actually smell like French fries, too. The fast food joint Del Taco recently unveiled a new soap that smells like those crinkle-cut fries. The lightly scented soap is called You do French fry, but you don't find it on the menu. The soap is only available for purchase online at deltacowebstores.com while supplies last. So, Todd, let's start with you. Do you want to smell like fries?
Do we have a Del Taco here?
No.
Okay, just saying. The answer is no. However, if you made a candle that smelled like bacon,
you would take
sizzling
it.
Bacon, I might be a little bit more inclined to get there, but right now, no on the French fries.
As about 30 or 40 dogs would be right behind right. you, no matter where you
They'd
go.
They'd be at the door and that's going, what's going on inside
that's
the house?
What I was going to say, I wouldn't want to be walking down the street and just attract like a
yeah,
whole gang
like,
of
what
street
is that?
And stuff. So I'd say thumbs down to the
thumbs down
to the French fries.
Latty, I know this is right down your
alley. I love Del Taco. I'm back from California. I went to Del Taco, and I would definitely get it, but I'd tweak it and make it chili cheese.
Cheese fries. Oh, okay.
As Emeril Lagasse would say, you're kicking it up a notch.
But do you think the ladies would like that?
No.
Simone? Yeah, I was going to say, no, we don't like that. That's not cute at all.
So at least not on the first date.
I'll wait till date three to be wearing my chili cheese fries.
You got to wait a while. She has to get used to you first before you start doing all that.
That would be different. Thank you guys so much. Glad to have you here.